We stopped here last time about the heat balance in a vision welding. We're still talking about the welding process. Previous time we discussed about the many details about the welding, and also we discussed about the power density or heat density. Today we're going to continuously discussing about the welding, the analysis of the welding, heat balance in the welding. The first thing we're going to discuss about is the unit melt in the welding. We have whatever we call is the unit melt in the welding. The unit melt or unit energy of the melting, unit energy UM here, the UM here meaning unit energy of the melt, which is a joule per cubic millimeter, joule per volume. Joule is the heat unit. Joule is the heat unit. Joule per cubic millimeter means joule per volume, per unit volume, equal to kT square m or Tm square. Tm, which is the melting temperature. Tm is the melting temperature of the material. Then K is a constant. K is a constant. And this K equal to here, let me just highlight. K is a constant, and this K here, this one, K is a constant equal to 3.33 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. 3.33, 10 power minus 6 when Kelvin scale is used. Kelvin mean melting temperature in Kelvin, not degree Celsius. We have to use melting temperature in Kelvin, and to obtain Kelvin temperature, Kelvin equal to degree Celsius plus 273 to get the Kelvin. If you have a degree Celsius, you add it 273, then you can get the Kelvin. Then this is the unit melt. Unit melt equal to K multiplied by Tm square, melting temperature square. What is the UM? UM is the unit energy or unit energy of melting temperature. Unit mean per unit volume, joule per unit volume. I can translate it in other words like this is the amount of the heat required to melt 1 cubic millimeter of the volume, only one cubic millimeter of this material, 1 cubic millimeter of this material. Why we do this? Why we have to concern about the unit volume? Because we put in a table. For example, aluminium, we bought UM for aluminium, we bought UM for steel, we bought UM for other different material, right? We put in the table. It is per unit volume, it is only for 1 cubic millimeter. What we will, if we would like to melt more than 1 cubic millimeter, if you would like to melt 10 cubic millimeter, what to do? Simply, you multiply UM by 10. If you multiply UM by volume, then you get the joule. If you need the amount of heat to melt certain amount of volume, you multiply by volume, then you get the UM for this volume. So unit melt or unit volume melt is joule per cubic millimeter. We put in the table for several material. This is the equation actually. This is a common equation being used in industry. Another equation here can be used also, which is UM equal to rho CTM minus T ambient or T atmosphere plus rho H. It's more complicated. It is not really very common. Tm is the melting temperature. This is the room temperature. Rho is the density. C is the specific heat. H is the heat vision. This one similar to what we have before. We used before in a casting, if you remember. It's very similar. But this one is not very common. For simplicity, we use this one. And consider room temperature is usually this one starting from room temperature 20 to 25. Then and for simplicity, this equation been used. Then UM is available in the table. UM is available. Now we put UM in a table. So we know UM for several material, aluminium, steel, copper, and so on. If you would like to know the heat required to melt certain volume of aluminium, then you get UM, you multiply by volume. You get UM, you multiply by volume, then you get the heat. This one, let's go to this one, then heat required for the welding, heat required for the welding, HW mean heat required for the welding equal to UM of this material. If you weld steel, if you weld steel here, then the heat required to do the welding here, which is UM, UM of what? UM of steel. From where? From the table. Or you can obtain as a K multiplied by TM square. TM is the melting temperature of this material. K 3.33 multiplied 10 power minus 6. Then it also can be used as a K TM square, or you can obtain from table for unit volume. UM is a joule per cubic millimeter. If you multiply by the volume, what volume? Volume of the weld. You multiply volume of the weld, this area, this volume. Then you multiply this volume, you get joule. You get joule, you get the amount of heat, you get the amount of heat required to weld this volume. Amount of heat, this H mean heat. HW is a word W heat for welding. Heat for welding, or heat required for welding. Then you get the heat required to weld this volume, required to weld this volume. If you don't understand anything, you stop me anytime. If not clear, you stop me. If you don't understand, just stop me, right? However, they said that welding usually done as not heat, but heat rate. Not heat, but heat rate. What is the heat rate? Heat rate is actually joule per second. So go back again. This is a joule. This is a joule heat. This is heat required to do all welding from beginning to the end. This is HW is the heat required to do the welding, all welding from beginning to the end. However, this weld not done in a second. This weld done, for example, for certain time, because the technician or the operator start to do welding from beginning here and so on and so on and so on and so on and so on. Finally he finished. How many minutes, how many seconds he do the welding in what time? Then in this case, if you divide this one, this is the heat. If you divide this one by the time, simply if you divide this one by the time, if you divide the heat, this heat, finally you have to, this heat required to do all the welding. If you divide by time, you get the heat rate, which is joule per second. What is, how many joule required every 1 second? If you divide by time, then how many joule required for every second? Then, for example, if this weld done in 10 seconds, then you divide this one by 10, you get in every one. Total heat is this one. This is the total heat. But this one, if you divide by T, you get heat rate, which is how this heat delivered. How this heat delivered. Every second deliver certain amount of heat, and every second deliver certain amount of, finally, total heat will be delivered. This one we call heat rate. Then the heat rate, this one we call heat rate RHW. RHW. HW is the heat rate. Then heat rate is what? Joule per second. This is a UMV, which is the HW. This one is the HW, which is equal to UMV. This is the HW, as you can see, divided by time. HW divided by time mean joule per second. UMV, the volume here, equal to A, this is a weld area, multiplied by the length, weld length. Then ALV equal to AL, divided by T. Then you can see that L divided by T, if you look to L divided by T, this is the area of the weld. UM is the unit melt area of the weld, and this is the L, length of the weld divided by T. You get the speed of the weld. Speed of the weld. Length divided by time, meaning speed. This is joule per second. Then you can say that. You can say that from here. Then it is equal to UM multiplied by the area of the weld. UM multiplied by the area of the weld, multiplied by the V. V, which is the LT. V is the speed of the weld. So this one is volume. Be careful. This one is volume. This one is the speed of the wind. Speed L divided by T, which is, for example, millimeter per second. Millimeter per second. This is the speed of the wind. So unit melt multiplied by AW multiplied by V, which is the speed of the wind. How fast, how slow this will happen. This AW, they call it AW. They call it RWV, like this, which is RWV. They call it as a volume rate. Volume rate, because AW, which is cubic millimeter per second, cubic millimeter area, millimeter square, millimeter per minute. Then cubic millimeter per minute, for example, this is a volume, cubic millimeter means volume rate of metal weld. Volume rate of metal weld. How many cubic millimeter will be weld every 1 second or every 1 minute? This is a volume rate of weld done. We call it volume rate of weld done. This is the RHW. This is the heat rate, joule per second. Listen to me carefully. Joule per second is a watt. This is a power. We call it heat rate or power. Same meaning. So joule per second, I can write joule per second is equal to watt, which is the power unit. So per second, what is a joule per second? Joule per second is the heat rate or watt, which is the power unit. So there are a joule, please don't be confused. Joule and joule per second. Joule is the heat. Joule per second is the heat rate, which is the power delivered. This is the power, heat rate. Joule per second is the power. Any question? Right. Okay, so let's agree. HW and RHW are here. HW and RHW are here in a weld area. So HW mean heat. Listen to me carefully, please. Please give me your attention. HW is the heat needed to do the welding. RHW is the heat rate need to do the welding. Both needed to do the welding. So HW is the heat needed to do the welding. RHW is the heat rate needed to do the welding. This is the source, actually. This is the weld source. This is the weld. This is the weld source. Source mean مصدر الحرارة. ده مصدر الحرارة. وده الولد. الحرارة المطلوبة لل... ده ال HW الحرارة المطلوبة عشان تعمل الولد هنا هو. وال RHW معدل الحرارة أو الباور المطلوب عشان نعمل الولدنج هنا. طيب إيه الباور اللي إحنا محتاجينه؟ What is the power needed to do the welding? Said that some heat delivered. Some heat, this is a source, some heat delivered from here to here will be dissipated. Some heat will be dissipated. Then this is a source, this is the weld. Some heat will be dissipated here. There are whatever we call F1 factor and F2 factor. F1 is the heat transfer, يعني الheat transfer من هنا لهنا, heat transfer performance. يعني مثلا يقول لك ايه F1 equal to 70%. يعني F1 equal to 70%, يعني 70% من الحرارة, 70% of the heat transmitted, heat will be transmitted 70%. What heat? The source heat. يعني الحرارة اللي عند السورس 70% هيتنقل. This is the F1. We call it is heat transfer performance. Heat, the loss is 1 minus F. Mean 70% will reach here, 30% will be lost in an environment. What else? There are F2. F2 is the heat used for melting or melting F. So let me say that F1, this is F1, is the heat transfer efficiency. F2, which is this one, we call it melting efficiency. What is the melting? So F1 here transfer efficiency. For example, I said 70%. if one equal to 70%, I understand that 70% will be transmitted from the source to the weld. If two melting efficiency, melting efficiency means that when this area or this surface receive this heat, some heat received from the source will be dissipated. Some heat from the source will be dissipated. Where? Dissipated in the material. Material is conducted. This is conducted material. Conducted material means some heat received on the surface will be lost, will be dissipated, and the balance, the remaining heat will be used in the welding. So how many percent of the heat will remain for the welding? Then you need to multiply the heat source, multiply by F1 and F2. So if, for example, if F1, for example, F1 70%, it means 0.7. F1 0.7, if F2 0.6. What does that mean? F1 0.7 means 70% of the heat transmitted to the surface. 0.6 means, F2 0.6 mean this heat received by the surface, 60% will remain for welding and 40% of that heat will be dissipated in thermal conductivity. Then what is the heat remaining? Heat, the heat, H is the heat, let me say H is the heat generated at source. RH is the heat rate delivered by source. Then the remaining, the HW equal to F1, F2H, RHW equal to F1, F2, RH. Then be careful between RH and RHW and H and HW. H, heat delivered at the source. H is the heat per joule delivered at the source. RH, heat rate delivered at the source, right? This H and RH, this H and RH, well transmitted to the surface, multiplied F1, and the remaining will multiply by F2. Then H multiply by F1 and F2, if H multiply by 70%, for example here, multiply by 70%, multiply by 60%, then you get remaining heat for welding. RH multiply by 70%, multiply by 60%, you get RHW remaining for welding. Did you get it? Any question? That's it. Here explain to you what is the F1, which is a heat transfer. This is the heat transfer efficiency. F2 is a melting efficiency. Melting efficiency mean remaining heat for welding, other will be dissipated in the thermal conductivity of material. Then you can say that you conclude that HW equal to F1, F2H, joule, which is heat, RHW, always HW and RHW smaller than H and RH. H and RH are bigger because H and RH, this is the heat source and heat rate source. HW and RHW is the balance, remaining heat for welding. Then always H and RH bigger than HW and RHW. This is the joule heat, this is the joule per second, which is the heat rate or power. Please listen to me carefully. This is really very important. Then, I understand that HW, which is the heat for welding, equal to F1, F2 multiplied by H, right, which is the heat source. This one, HW equal to what? From previous, we said HW equal to UM multiplied by V. V is the volume of the weld. Then UM multiplied by V is equal to F1, F2H. The second equation, we have RHW, which is the heat rate for welding, or needed for weld, equal to F1, F2, RH as the source, equal to also UM, A, area of the well, V, speed of the well, joule per second, or what? This is the two equations that we have in the welding. Those are the two equations we have in the welding. Any question? Guys, any question? Please remember these two equations. This is very important two equations, but you must understand. You must understand. Don't just memorize. You must understand what is that mean. If you have any question, you can ask me. Perfect. So this is the two equations. One for heat, another one for what? Heat rate, joule per second. What is a joule per second? What? The power. We can call it heat rate or power. All time, remember. Remember that. Okay. Let's take an example. Let's take an example. Let's read together and understand. Let's read together and understand. The power source. What? Power source. Source. What source? What's the source? Source is here. Now I'm talking about source. Right? The power source in a particular well. What particular? Any welding. It doesn't matter. The power source in a particular welding setup generates 3,500 watt. 3,500 watt. Where in the source? Power source. And he said what? What is that mean? Joule per second. Then the power source here, this one, deliver RHW. Where in the source? This is RH, I'm sorry. This is the RH. Deliver RH equal to this one, RH. RH. Then, power source, this guy, deliver 3,000. This source deliver 3,500 watt joule per second that can be transmitted to the work. This one will be transmitted to the workpiece surface. With a heat transfer factor. This is a heat transfer factor, F1. This is the F1, let me highlight, 0.7. This is the F1, 0.7. And then the metal to be welded is the low carbon steel, whose melting temperature is equal to, melting temperature is 1760 degree Kelvin, remember, degree Kelvin. This is very important. The melting factor is what? Is F2.5. Then I understand that F1 heat transfer 70%, melting factor 50%. 50% will remain, 50% will dissipate in the workpiece material. And then here, continuous discussion, a continuous fillet well. This is a continuous fillet. This is a fillet well. This is a fillet well. He said that a continuous fillet well, which is this one, you have to remember now. This one I'll not show you. I'm show you here to understand, but in a problem, when I give you, ask you, I will not show you this figure. Then you have to imagine, you have to understand. A continuous fillet weld is to be made with a cross-section area. Area is here. This is the cross-section area, 20 millimeter square. This is the area, cross-section area, millimeter, 20 millimeter square. The weld area, 20 millimeter square. Determine speed. We need to know what is the travel speed or the weld speed. RH given. UM not given. So RH given. So we know that we need the speed. We need to know the speed. Speed. The question is, what is the speed of the weld? Put the equation. Immediately put the equation. This is the equation. Equation said that this is the equation. RHW. I don't have. Equal to F1, F2, RH equal to UM, AW multiplied by V. I don't have RHW, but I have RH. RH is given. This is the RH, 3,500 is the RH is given. F1 is given. This is the F1, which is a unit melt. This is the F2. This is the heat transfer factor and the humidity factor. This is F1 given, F2 given, RH given. Then I can apply here again, get RHW. Then I know RHW. RHW equal to what? Equal to UM multiplied by AW multiplied by V. I would like to have V. What is the V? The question, what is the V? Then I would like to have V. AW is given. This is the AW, which is the area of the weld. Area is given here. This is the area, 20 millimeter. UM, I don't know. I don't know UM. Then I have to calculate. Then UM equal to what? UM equal to KTM square. K equal to 3.33, 10 power minus 6. This is the K, the constant. This is the K multiplied by melting temperature square. Melting temperature in Kelvin, not in degree Celsius. If you don't have, if you have melting temperature in degree Celsius, you have to add it 273. Then this one must be in Kelvin. This constant used with Kelvin, then you put the temperature in Kelvin square, then you get UM. This is UM. Then you apply UM here, then you can obtain the speed of the weld. Speed of the weld. Right? Then you apply here. Then speed of the weld. This is the speed of the weld equal to F1 multiplied by FRH divided by UMAW. 0.7, 0.5, 3500 multiplied by, divided by 10. 0.3 multiplied by AW, which is 20, then you get the speed of the weld, 5.95 millimeter per second. 5.95 millimeter per second. This is the speed of the weld. Right. Any question? Any question? Guys, any question?
Yeah, doctor.
Is it clear? Fine. Yeah. This is very important, really. This is very important. You can feel that it is nice and you understand and so on, but you have to practice. I'm telling again, you must practice by hand. I suggest you to solve this one by hand. When you study, solve this one by hand and use a calculator and try to solve it to understand the fundamental and principle. We have RH, RHW. We have H and HW. What is the difference? You must understand. This one deliver at the source or at the weld. This is big different. Then please keep in mind. Okay, let's go to another example. This is a really nice example. I would like you to give me your full attention. Please, full attention. Let's read and understand together. A local company is performing a gas tungsten arc welding. It doesn't matter gas tungsten arc welding, whatever. Anyway, operation on low carbon steel. This is a raw material. This is a weld process. The welding process is conducted use power source. This is a power source. Listen to me carefully, please. This one very important. This is a power source. This is a heat rate, joule per second or power watt. This is a power source given. RH is given. Heat transfer factor is given, F1. Melting factor also is given, F2. Failure material wire, failure material. There are a failure here. Failure here. Failure added. Could be added separately or could be, failure may be added separately or maybe electrode itself is used as a failure. It doesn't matter. Anyway, failure wire is the failure diameter, the wire diameter. This one important. Failure wire diameter is 3.85 millimeter. This is the failure diameter. The diameter of the failure, 3.85 millimeter diameter, is added to the operation. Yeah, you know that we added failure to the operation to compensate and so on, added bulk and so on. So we added failure so that the final weld bead, the final weld bead, the final weld bead volume consists of the final weld. This is the final weld. This is the final weld, right? after complete, this is a final, this is the gray color, this is a weld joint. A final weld consists of 58% filler. This one consists of 58% filler and 42% base metal. Okay. So this one, not only base metal and filler. Do you understand that? Because we, when we do heating here, we melt the two base material, you get liquid mix, but filler is added also. So he said that 58% filler, 42% is the base material. The unit melting energy for this material is 11 points. The unit melt, UM, unit melt. Unit melt is given for this material that we're welding. He says that if the weld speed in the operation 4.5 millimeter per second, this is the weld speed is given. Weld speed is given. Determine first cross-sectional area of the weld bead. What is the area of this weld? What is the cross-sectional area of the weld? This is the first question. Second question, what is the feed rate at which filler wire must be supplied? Let's take one by one, cross-sectional area. We need to get the area. Put the equation. You know that. Immediately, put the equation. Put the equation. We are power. We're dealing with the power. Then put the power equation, because we're dealing with the power. Someone will say, why we use power equation? Why you don't use heat equation? Because he said that here, power given as power. Power is delivered to the well. Then use a power equation. Don't use a heat equation, because we have heat rate. Then use the heat rate equation. Put the equation. This is the power equation. Say that F1, F2R, HUM, AV. What is needed? Area. We need to know the first question, what is the area of the weld? We need to know the area. Area is unknown. We need to know. What is given? UM given. You can see that. Let me just highlight. UM given. This is a UM given. You understand? And V is given. Speed of the weld given and UM given. Area we would like to know. We don't know. We would like to know the cross-section area. F1 given, F2 given, RH given. F1 given, F2 given, RH given. Then we need to obtain area. Area easily can be obtained. F1, F2, RH divided by UMV. Then you can apply, get the area. Any question? I think this one easy. This one easy. Second one is really important. Second one is really important. Read it. Second question is, what is the feed rate in millimeter per second at which the filler wire must be supplied? The feed rate, the filler wire will be supplied. What is the feed rate filler will be supplied? Because filler will be melted, then you need to feed. Because will melted. If you don't feed, this one will not continuous. Then as this one is melt and deposited, then you need to continuously feed this one. The question is, what is the feed speed? What is the feed rate, millimeter per second, that we can continuously feed the wire, the filler wire? What is the feed rate that we continuously feed the wire? This is the question. Here, we talk about, just listen to me carefully. We talk about the volume of the weld. The volume of the weld equal to AWV. AWV, right? You agree? This is the area we know, we obtain from here. Area we know, and velocity you know. This is the volume of the weld. Please listen to me carefully. This is the volume rate. This is the volume rate of the weld. Not volume, but volume rate of the weld. This one. Not volume, but volume rate, cubic millimeter per second. This is the volume rate of the weld. Every second, in a welding, we deliver 163.3 cubic millimeter of the weld material. Every second, this is the volume rate of the weld. right? This volume, 58% filler, this one, 58% filler and 42% balance, 42% base material. Okay. Then you multiply. Now we would like to focus on the wire. We need to focus on the wire because he asked me what is the feed rate of the filler material or the wire material, which is the 58. Then 58% is wire. Then I need to obtain what is the feed rate, right? Feed rate. Then I need to obtain, he already gave me wire diameter. Wire diameter is given. Then from the wire diameter, I can obtain the area, wire area. This is the wire. I have wire diameter. I obtain wire area. Wire area equal to pi d squared divided by 4. This is the wire diameter is given. This is the wire area. This is the wire area. And wire volume, the wire volume delivered, the wire volume delivered to this one equal to 58% of this volume. 58% of the volume delivered to the weld is wire. Then you bring here, then 163 multiplied by 58%. This is the volume rate of the wire delivered, which is the cubic millimeter per second of the wire, only wire delivered to the weld. If you divide by area, which is millimeter square, you get millimeter per second, which is the wire feed rate. This is the volume rate of the wire. Volume rate of the wire. You divide by the wire area, volume rate, cubic millimeter per second. You divide by the wire area, which is the millimeter square, you get feed rate or the feed speed millimeter per second that you need to feed the wire to the welding zone. Is it clear? Any question? Any question?
Clear, doctor.
Perfect. So, still, if you need to ask me, you can ask me anytime. That's it. Finish the analysis. Finished. Then talk about the feature of the vision weld. Feature of the vision weld, actually, you can see that this is a weld. Vision weld. When said vision weld, what is the vision weld? Liquid state welding. Liquid. Now we talk about vision weld. Vision weld is, we have three area actually. We have a base metal. This is a base metal. This is a weld area. This is the vision zone. Let me just highlight. This is the vision zone. This is the weld zone here. Where material, this is the weld zone. We call it vision zone. Where material melted and weld done. This is the one. And then we have whatever we call heat affected zone. This one and this one is heat affected zone. You can see that here and here is not melted. If you can see that, this area and this area not melted. Only this area is melted. So well done here, only here. This area actually not melted, but as you can see here, affected by the heat. Can you see that? The color here different. Why? Because this area affected. What does that mean? Affected by the heat. Affected by the heat means structure of the material here change. Why? Because material heated up to critical point where material recrystallized and material structure changed. The heat was, heat at this area was very high to change the structure of the material. So we call it heat affected zone. Yes, it is not melted by heat affected zone. And then the other area of the part we call it is the base area. We call it the base metal. Base metal mean this area not affected by the heat. Yes, it is heated because usually heat dissipated. Yes, heated, but no significant effect. No significant, then nothing will happen. Material structure here still remaining same. Only this area, material structure, change, we call heat affected zone. So we have three zones: vision zone, weld zone, this heat affected area, and then this is a Bayes metal. Is it clear? So this is a vision area. This is a vision area. Vision area mean the area, weld area. This is the heat affected area around heat affected area. And this is a Bayes metal not affected. Then here also, this is the structure of the, this is a vision. This is the heat affected area. You can see that the microstructure change here. And the balance is the Bayes material. This is the three, this is a three zone in a welding process. In this area, you can see that this area material here will be melted and solidify and well done in this area. And this area can be, you can see that, you can realize that it is different from method to method. This one is a laser welding. This one is arc welding. This one is a gas welding. What is the big difference? The big difference here in laser here, high heat density. High heat density means it is narrow and deep, because the heat density is very high. Here you can see that it is more wider, and also heat affected zone here is very little compared with this one. Heat affected zone here is bigger. This is a gas, for example, it is distributed among big area. You can see it is very wide and shallow, very wide and shallow, not very deep like this. And then here that heat affected zone is very big. Then if I ask you a question, if you would like to do welding with very, very small or with a smaller heat affected area, what weld type to be used? High power density, low power density? High power density. Then I use weld type with a high power density. High power density to get small heat affected zone. Is it clear, guys? This is very important. This is a very common question in multiple choice and true and false. High power density, small affected area. Low power density, as you can see here, big affected area. Is it clear? Right. If you would like to get a narrow and deep, high power density. If you would like to get shallow and wide, low power density. This kind of terminology must be clear in your mind. So this one very important, right? It's a very common question in choice and true and false. Yes, Muhammad.
D is undesirable, صح؟ ما نبغاها.
Yeah, we don't want. Yeah, actually, yes, as Muhammad said, this one is very wide. Very wide means this is very low power density. This is very, we cannot say manibghaha, because this one is being used also in the well. This one is very cheap. Laser one is very expensive, but we talk about another point of view, quality. We talk about weld quality. Weld quality in laser welding better than weld quality in a gas welding. It doesn't mean that gas welding, we're not going to use gas welding. Gas welding be used in a weld also, because very cheap and very common also, available everywhere in industry, in factory, and so on. Also arc beam welding or arc welding, this gas welding, arc welding also being used in a company, in industry. Both are being used, but what I'm talking about is something else. Whether we need it or not, not talking about whether we need it or not, we talk about the quality. Weld quality in a laser welding better than weld quality in gas and arc welding. But it doesn't mean that we don't have this. We have it. Why you ask me why we have it? Why you didn't just simply use a laser welding? Because laser welding is very expensive. Equipment is very expensive. Not common everywhere, but quality is better. But if you really need for aerospace, for example, for some application like aerospace application and very advanced application and very sensitive material and so on, welding could be the solution. But for common welding in industry, I mean welding steel in industry and so on, commonly use gas and arc welding. Not use laser beam welding. Doesn't matter, actually. Quality is not that really very important. We're not that much concerned about quality in industry. You understand what I said?
Yes, doctor. Thank you.
Perfect. Yeah, this is the issue. But remember, I'm talking about quality now. If I ask you, What is a well type provides the lowest heat affected zone, smallest heat, low power density or high is in high power density. Laser or arc welding is in laser. You understand? You have to understand this. This is the zone actually in three phase diagram. This is liquid. This is a liquid. This is a solid. This is a solid area. Temperature here, this is affected. Temperature here in a critical zone, but no melting. This one is liquid. This one in a liquid zone. This one in a solid zone, but temperature here critical mean material structure change here. Lower temperature than material not even affect. Temperature zero or temperature, but material not affected with the temperature significantly actually. Okay, let me say that. Okay, let me say that vision world, I remind you, metallurgical property of heat affected zone vision will depend on metal that you join, welding process, filler material and the process variable. As I just mentioned, material, it depends on the material that you weld. The vision heat affected zone depend on the material you weld. Weld the process, you use laser, you use gas weld, you use arc welding, it's different. So it affected zone affected from one to one. Filler material use, yes, also it depends on the filler material use, what type of the filler also affecting it affected zone. And process variable like weld speed, low welding, fast welding, and so on, depend on. So heat affected zone depend on these variables. To remind you, autogenous is a weld without filler material. Still, I didn't show. Next chapter, in chapter 26, we'll show some example about autogenous. Autogenous means it is a vision. Be careful, autogenous is a vision weld and no filler material being used. Commonly filler material used in a vision welding, but very few cases, filler material not used in a vision welding. We call it autogenous. I'll give you some example in next chapter 26. Weld metal that central zone of the joint and so on, that it's concerning what we just described earlier. You can see that this is shallow, wide and shallow, deep and narrow. Wide and shallow, deep and narrow. I'll be if you understand what I would like to say. This one is high power densities and give you narrow, deep. This one low power densities and give you wide and shallow. This one like gas welding, this one like laser beam or electron beam welding. So a structure usually like this. This is usually the material structure. This one is a column lamellar. This is a columnar. Columnar, this one is lamellar structure in both cases in weld process. Okay, so this is the end of this chapter, chapter 25. Next is 26, inshallah. We're going to start next time in 26. Let me stop recording.